What's up, guys? Welcome to Kickin' It with OGs. I'm Curtis Linden, designer and collector of vintage 80s, 90s apparel.
I started this series so you could have a better understanding of some of the original sneaker models that I've acquired, how they hold up over time, how they compare to the retros, and what it's going to take to make them wearable again.
I didn't have all this information when I started, so hopefully now you'll be able to decide for yourself whether or not they're worth your time and money in 2015. Today we're going to be talking about the Air Command Force, released in 1991, signature model for David Robinson, and made famous by White Men Can't Jump, Billy Hoyle. The shoe was the first Nike shoe, the second Nike shoe, after the Air Pressure, to have the pump system. Here we have the 2014 Retro, after 23 long years awaited. A lot of people really happy about it, as I was one of them. But after I got the Retro, I soon realized that I was just going to use these for donors. They're really nothing like the original. They call these shoes retros for that exact reason. They are replicas. They're replicas of what once were performance sneakers. They look like it, but they're not built like it. One of the biggest things you notice right away is the toe box of this is almost curved up. When you look at the original, it's even my cameraman said, and he's not even super into sneakers, that it just looks more natural. This looks like a shoe that you'd wear for performance. This looks like a replica of this shoe. The toe boxes are just completely different. The shape of the cut, the size of the perforation. This is like a suede, and this here we have Durabuck. They tried to replicate the look of the tongue, but this being that synthetic leather, they were able to get those curves that I told you that they couldn't do with regular leather. You can see the air hole for the pump is much closer to the eyelets than they are in the retro. And the retro pump seems to be much more defined compared to the subtle OG air pump. So the biggest complaint about the Retro Command Force is that they squeak when you wear them. I've worn a few times and they don't squeak because of the pump. They squeak because of the abundance of this just crappy leather. The leather on the Command Force originals is very thick cut, high quality. These have been worn really a lot and still holding up very well. So as you can see just from the shape of the shoes, as well as all the other differences I mentioned, the retro shoes are really just a replica. That's all they are. They're made to look like the original, the authentic. This looks like it. It does. But it is not anywhere near close to the performance shoe that this one was, and could be once repaired with a new midsole. This pair here is in great condition, in my opinion. Great candidate for a swap. You really want to swap pairs that have been worn, because then you can wear them guilt-free, basically. Not worrying about ruining the condition of a really rare or old shoe. Then you have stuff like this that you keep in a bag that looks like it's a retro from 2014, but is actually an original from 1991. The synthetic leather on this pair is not as yellow as this pair. So we're looking at a much closer representation of what it looked like on release day. And then we also have an amazing condition, the emerald colorway. So, this pair is unrestored, in amazing condition. But I have a pair here that I did restore. It was actually the first shoe I ever restored. You can see the Durabuck has already started to chip off here, and that's just from wearing old shoes with delicate materials on them. I used the same size midsole on this one, and it fit pretty nicely. There's some overhang a little bit here, but I'm not that picky. I don't know too many people who even have a pair of these swapped with the correct midsole. So here we have the Command Force 180, which was part of the 180 series that Nike did. They had Air Max 180. The Air 180 was this oversized Air unit. They also used the Air Max 180 as well. So the Air Max unit combined with the new dual pump system, which this dial here, you would pump up the upper ankle, as you can hear that. And then you could turn the dial and start pumping up the inside inner arch of the foot. And to release the air, pretty sweet. This pair is a very rare colorway. Normally I see them in this colorway, which is the David Robinson Spurs colorway. This pair I restored and I used the retro to get the donor. And as you can see, the retro looks nothing like the original. They're missing the pump. The upper itself is so flimsy. This was one of the highest priced Nikes at the time when it came out. I think this came out for maybe $80 or $90. They just didn't really put much effort into making this a quality shoe. They left out the corduroy on the inside. They changed the back. They kept the tag, but the shape, that shape, missing the air pump is just crucial. You can't miss that. That's what makes the shoe. So for this pair, in the current condition, you'd be looking for around, these days, around like $250, $300. About 2 years ago, these shoes would have been around $800, $1,000. But since the retro came out, a lot of the collectors really just want to be able to wear them. For these ones, same thing. Let's say these are going to go for around $300. I love this pair, it's my favorite pair. I would suggest getting any of these pairs, they're great, they're healthy. I've worn these more than any shoe that I've worn in the last year and a half, and it's still holding up. These may not be the best sole swap, but I love them, I wear them all the time, and it definitely makes me happy knowing I have a pristine pair backed up, waiting to be swapped once these do finally die on me. Now this pair, along with the Spurs colorway, these ones go for a little more money because the retros that came out for this pair just weren't anything close. At least the retros for the Command Force were semi. I think I've seen them posted for $1,000. They probably sell in the $500 range. Most of the people looking for these are hardcore fans because they're just a very rare shoe and not many people even know about them. It's likely we'll never see a true retro of the Command Force 180, simply because the technology and overabundance of use of materials just would not be warranted in today's basketball leagues. And anyway, it would just be a retro. It would just be a replica anyway. Coming in between me and my dreams.